that Michael Jackson has had a heart attack.
Jackson is dead. The king of pop has died.
Hey, there's my face in the clouds right there. Hey, Steve Owen, check your bad self. Ow!
Michael, you're gonna love it here. They've got all the pick and mix you can eat. They've got Tupperware. They've got these little LED lights that you press to turn on and you press to turn off. It's bonza, mate.
Steve, let me get this straight. You saying they got a Woolworth up here in heaven?
That's exactly what I'm saying, you fucking ding-dong.
Ain't so bad. Hi, y'all. I'm Michael Jackson, and I'm recently deceased. But don't cry for me, motherfuckers, because it was a bad, invincible ride down there. Shit, it was off the wall. So stay with me for my one-hour tribute as we take a look back at my history. That's right, Jamon, motherfucker. Hee-hee, ow!
Like Jackson all my life, and that's not because I'm black and he were black and all, because I liked him when he was white. It didn't matter if he were black or white. You bastard, yeah. No, but I did like him when he was black, and he sang with those other black lads. There were four of them. That's five black lads in total. Thought it was amazing. Oh, aye. Bunton's here. Morning, Emma.
Mel.
Didn't see you at bingo last night.
Oh, I went to a posh do.
Posh do, eh? All right, for some. No, but yeah, I like that song that he did that was about alphabet. That was my favourite.
We're the Jackson 5. Check it out! It's as easy as A, B, motherfucking C! What the fuck? What's up with you, Daddy? Why are you beating on me?
Motherfucker, what did I tell you about seeing motherfucker on live TV?
You say motherfucker more than I say motherfucker. Where do you think that I get motherfucker from?
That's because I am a motherfucker, motherfucker. I fucked your mother, and you wouldn't be here if I wasn't a motherfucker, motherfucker.
I remember Jackson 5 TV show. It was all very vivid and orange, like porno colours.
Oh, yeah.
You know when it's too bright and it shivers?
Oh, I know what you're saying, yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, y'all. My name is Michael, and this is my brother Jermaine, Jackie, Marlon, and Tito. And together, we're the Jackson 5. And welcome to the Jackson 5 show. Oh! We're going to be called the Brady Bunch. We're all black and shit. Oh! That be the door. I get it. Hey, Jermaine, who is this turkey?
Yes, you may come on a biscuit.
Michael, what the fuck is up with you? Can't you see I'm getting my flabber-stabber in the do-wrong, brother?
Hey, Marlon, who is this turkey?
Shit, Megan, can't you see that I'm getting some stank for my hang low?
Hey, Tito, who is this turkey?
I
can never understand what he say.
Back up. Press back up. You press back up. Press back. No, I am English, yes. No, this is not... I'm not speaking in Bombay, no. Right, you press back... Hold on a second, Mr. Scoff-Cockiness. Well, yeah, I was a massive fan of Michael Jackson. If it wasn't for him, I don't think that I'd be singing. I was particularly a fan of the song that he did that was about now, a banana. No, it wasn't a banana, because I don't even like bananas. It was a potato, not a potato, but it was a turtle. It was a peacock, a Tupperware box.
This song go out to one of my true friends, Splintay Direct, from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. He was in a motherfucking half share. Until he poochie-ribbed my jelly donut, then the only show that I had to cry on was my other brother,
Ben Stiller from the movie Something About Mary, starring that fine pussy Tang Tang, Cameron Diaz, where she gets that man gravy in the head, and he gets his cockasaurus caught in a zipper fly. Well, this song goes out to you, motherfucker, so check it out. Been dodging them bars. Been in them museum halls. Been being all jolly. But I wasn't all keen on the movie along came Polly. It stunk like a skunk's pussy and asshole, motherfucker. That film was whack. Now why don't you call me Shalmon and get me in the follow-up movie, Meet the Motherfuckers, bitch?
I mean, Ben, what a beautiful song. Hey, talk about ahead of its time as well. Miles ahead, Ben Stiller wasn't even invented then.
Well, that's the genius of Michael Jackson, isn't it? That he's...
He was like a young Nostradamus.
Yeah, who's that?
I potentially invented Michael Jackson. The whole thing was my idea.
That's the thing. Let me tell you something. I remember the time that Michael and I were recording the album Off the Wall, right here in this very studio. After each line in the song, Michael would persistently say the words E-I-O and da. Now let me tell you something. I can't drive. I cannot drive. It's an impossibility. But I do know the future of hip-hop. And I know that E, Out, and there is not the future of hip-hop. So I told Michael so.
Ow, there's Susie. Ow. Don't stop. Till you get enough. Ow. Chicken, motherfucker. Ow. Ow.
Hey, Michael. we're going to go again because you keep saying E, Out, and there and making shit noises.
Do I? I keep saying that?
Yeah, like a dime a dozen. So we'll go again from the top, son.
Let's do it again, Shamon.
Michael, you're doing it again. Let me tell you something. You know that I can't drive, but I do know that farmyard animal noises ain't gonna sell records. Why, you a pig? Or you a goat? Or you a cock-a-doodle-doo? Or a ba-ba and a moo-moo and a billy-boo-boos? Come on, son, let's start again.
Chris A, this be my new shit right now. The kids are gonna dig it the moose. That was smooth. That was smooth like butte. I don't believe that be butte. That was butte, motherfucker. So you better leave that in. Chris A, you're out of time.
So Michael and I had a little falling out over this matter, and I broke Michael's nose. I can't drive, but I do have free feet, and one of those feet knows kung fu. It's specifically that one there. I got free feet.
After a mysterious accident involving one of Quincy Jones's free feets, Michael Jackson came to me for his first rhinoplasty, which of course is Greek Latino for nose fix. Not to be confused with rhino pasty, which is a pasty made out of rhino meat, beans, cocks, and balls. Michael first went public with his rhinoplasty in the video for Don't Stop Until You Get Enough Cola Cubes.
The mothers!
Dollar bills, y'all, from Michael Jackson, I prescribed him with a powerful painkiller called Lucozade Tablet. Of course, Tablet being the collective for tablet. One, maybe two tablet. Well, that's just some tablet. Seven, maybe eight. Well, that's tablet.
everybody at the time was addicted to Lucozade Tablet.
The Tablet was just a sweetie, but I kept on supplying Michael with the sweetie to help feed my addiction for sweet hookers, which I like to make love to in the poo-poo.
You know, Emma, Michael Jackson got 7 Grammys for Thriller. He got 7 Grammys.
Seven.
How many Grammys have we got? Listen.
None.
Huh?
I really appreciate winning these 7 Grammys right here. It's gonna come in useful for when I'm keeping the back door open for the lame. If you wanna come in, if you so choose, you like to chow down on some karate from the pantry.
I invented the Grammys. Potentially, as you'll see, it's before a live studio audience. That was my idea. I think it works.
Thank you very much. Have a great night. Brooke Shields, you look tight. Your ass look tight, motherfucker. Good night. And then we've got a bag for all of this. I can't carry this all night, Shyamalan. What the fuck?
We haven't won a Grammy?
No.
Well, we must have won one for Sig a Cigar or Spice Up Your Life or Two Can Be One.
No, none.
We're not even for Two Can Be One.
No, we've got MTV Awards, Brits.
MTV Awards.
American Music Awards.
American Music Awards, Brits.
Yep.
For Smash Hits.
Yeah.
Did we get a Super Drug Award for Best Makeup?
No.
And we've not got a Grammy?
No, we've not got a Grammy.
You greedy Grammy bastards, I'm going to phone someone.
You should do that.
I'm going to... I will do.
Phone her.
I will. I'll phone someone, Emma. I will. Who do I phone?
I don't know.
Well, I'll fucking phone someone. Here, take that. I'll phone someone.
Mel.
I'm phoning someone. What number?
I love Thriller. I thought it was probably one of the greatest videos ever.
Thought Thriller video really good. Because that bird were out nice looking. I'd like to have a go on that. Ibsen Dussie in us!
I tell you what we're going to do. Obviously, we've been speaking about Thriller. They're going to show a clip. It's a tedious link to Thriller, this. I tell you that. I would never write anything like this. I'm going to think of something rude about Peaches, probably me doing it in the mouth with her, and then I'll have it out at the end of the cliff. Don't worry. Here it comes.
This is John Landis. This is the crazy bastard that directed Thriller Night.
I get a phone call, 3 a.m, I'm in Newquay. I'm like, hello, who's this?
It's Michael Jackson.
I'm like...
That's right.
I was crazy, I couldn't believe it was him. I came round his house, we chibber-rabbered.
You know what, John? You were a lot nicer than I thought you would be.
What do you think I was gonna be, Mike? A monster?
A bit more faggot, too.
Yeah, we sat there and we had a coffee and I went through my body of work and I was like, Mike, have you heard of Bergerac?
No.
The Maxwell House advert?
No.
Catfile?
No.
Have you heard of Lovejoy?
No.
What about Boone?
Boone? What's that? Some documentary about a monkey with a fucked up ass?
It's Michael Elphick. He drives around on a motorbike solving crimes.
I saw the movie he did, Cockney Wealth in London, England.
Hello? Is there someone there?
Roar! Roar! I'm the Cockney werewolf!
Oh, my!
And I'm gonna eat ya!
Oh, my! Is there anything I can do to deter you from doing such a terrible thing?
Have you got an iPhone?
Yes, I do.
And do I need a PC or a Mac to work this?
It works on both.
Well, I'll have that then. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I thought that was some crazy shit. I said, that's the Poochie River. We gotta get to Direct Thriller Night.
Poochie River?
That's right.
Homeboy, that's only best friends call each
Poochie
other
Poochie River, right there,
yeah,
Shyamalan.
Definitely.
So I said to John, I want to be a werewolf all over the perimeter of the face, that's right.
Sorry, it just didn't scare her.
Ah, the bitch be right.
the moon!
Awful John, earwax problem. He's got to get his ears rinsed about twice a month. Mike, what's up, man? What's
this
up, dude?
Ain't scary. I look like some Andrew Lloyd Webber catchy, motherfucker. Pussy ain't scary unless it's your mother's.
Oh, God, I know you didn't. Two friends. Yeah, your mum's pussy is like a sea monster. It's like Moby Dick's mouth back there.
John, your mother's pussy is so big, it got its own ecosystem.
He's done it. Yeah, your mum's is like
men.
Cheese. It's like rotten cheese. It seriously pongs.
You just say that my mother got a pongy pussy? You join the line right there. That's that motherfucker. For the rest of the shoot, I want to be a zombie. That's right.
Let's do it, motherfucker. Let's get this guy made into a zombie.
I want lots of zombies all around the place.
Let's litter the place with zombies, Pam.
Food zombies, John. Yeah. Food zombies.
Food zombies.
Because check
let's
this,
get some
John.
Food zombies
we
in
eat here. The food, but what about the food eaters? That is
we can make them carrots and broccoli.
Yeah, I want broccoli. I want the spring onion, motherfucker.
A spring onion zombie.
Now pick me up we're having a good time.
Come here. Two besties.
Put me down, John. Put me down, John.
Oh, man, give me some
love. Motherfucker.
Oh, God, that guy. Right, food zombies. Let's have a call on food zombies.
I am deep with a hooker that smell like vegetables before.
It does smell a little bit like food. I can smell
corn on the cob.
I can smell bacon.
Darkness falls across the land. Food zombie monsters are close at hand. Corn on the cob, pizza and egg. They walk real slowly but will kill you dead. The foulish stenches, they're all out of date. They're going to eat you as well as your mate. And although you fight to stay alive, your pants begin to fill with cake. If I was you, I'd turn around and run for fuck's sake.
Oh my God, there's food zombies! I'm terrified!
I potentially invented food zombies. It was my idea.
For no queer mortal can resist the scariness of the thriller. Shoot yourself, haven't you? Shoot yourself a little bit. Definitely shit yourself.
I'm a KFC chicken drumstick zombie motherfucker, you bastard.
What Michael was like?
What was he like?
Yes, what was he like?
Sad question.
It's an odd question.
Oh, it was. Do you know what? It was mystical.
He's dancing. I'm talking about his dancing. You get these kids.
Mystical.
You get these kids that do it all the life. Michael comes in and the boy gets it like that. He got it straight like that, didn't he?
Oh my God. There's something really disturbing about that.
Just take it on and off really quickly, then put it on again, then take it off. And then it'll feel like I've got a foreskin now and being wanked off.
Myself, I'm not very musical, but Michael has inspired me with my drawings. See, here's some of my drawings. Here is a drawing of Michael singing, and here is a drawing of Michael swimming, and here is a drawing of Michael singing. He has sinned, for he has chopped off the head of E.T. because he loves him so much. But there is no vengeance on E.T.'s part. As you can see, he's singing a beautiful song to Michael. It goes like this. Don't worry, Michael. You have killed me. I am a little cloud up so high. Watch me now. Watch me now. I can take pain.
I can take pain.
Awesome, Brian.
Moon, that's right. Oh, it's a beautiful day, motherfucker. Hey, bastard, I didn't know you were filming. Motherfucker, let me come down. That's right, it's too deep. Ow, Jamon, this is a bad day, motherfucker. This is the most beautiful part of the day, the dawn. I love the dawn, and the dawn loves me. Jamon, here's my bad self. That's right. Check it out. I got the elephant man bones. You can buy this shit from IKEA. It's the elephant man bones lampshade ensemble. That's right. today I'm gonna do some painting. Check this out, because this helped me be all creative when I'm doing my songs and shit. So I'm painting my best motherfucking bitch right down here, Liz Taylor, bitch. Liz Taylor, you all right?
I'm fine, Michael, I'm fine. Just get the painting done, you little motherfucker. Liz Taylor wants to go to Taco Bell.
That's right. So I'm using burgundy and blue. So check it out. This is what we got. This is what we got. Burgundy, 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 burgundy. Blue, 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 blue. Back to burgundy, 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 burgundy. And that's Billie Jean right there. I just invented that before your very motherfucking eyes. You can go buy that. Say that shit. It's true. Ow! Ow! She was more like a caramel or like a green. She had the biggest clit I seen that I have with so fun. Get the chicken, get the chicken, get the chicken on.
Get the chicken.
Jam on, cut the scene. Who be the lady square man? Who be the lady square? Is that the right terminology? The lady square man? Who the lady square man? Bitch! You be the lighty square man. When I step on the lighty square, it gotta light up. You're trashing the sheen, Shamoon. Motherfucker, this is twice this happened. Are you Rain Man? What the fuck's going down? You're a nice guy. But you're gonna get a sparkly sock in your motherfucking ass. And that gonna cut you up. Shamoon, when I step on it, they come on like that. Ow! Check this. See? That should light up. That's right, it light up, see? When I step on the lighted square, that motherfucker gonna light up! That's it. MJ gonna get his milk break! Ow!
That's true and deep, you know that.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Oh, I remember the first time we did Moonwalk.
Oh.
It was good, wasn't it?
Neil Armstrong. What a day that was.
No Michael Jackson.
Eh?
Can look like he is walking forward, but he is going backwards. It's crazy shit.
Moon.
When he's dancing.
On the moon or what?
When he's dancing and walking.
Neil Armstrong.
No, that's first man on moon. You dingbat.
Moonwalk.
Check this. You like that, right? You like that, right? You like that, right?
This is me doing balloon animals. It's a lame. It's a lame right there. You know that. Ow! Let's see, doing embroidery. There's ET right there. I'm going back because we look like I'm forward right now. Ow!
Of course, I invented the moonwalk, potentially.
This is me going backwards drinking a cup of tea like the queen motherfucker does in England. That's right, Shamoon.
It's a popular misconception that he came up with a moonwalk because we invented it. He stole it from us. We're probably more recognisable as the characters we portrayed, Ozone and Turbo, in the film Breakdancing the Film. What I'm saying is, he didn't invent the moonwalk, we did.
Well, he borrowed it.
He didn't borrow it at all, he stole it from us.
No, he borrowed it creatively.
Have you heard, you? We get the chance to put the record straight and you're going against migraine.
Yeah, you said it, migraine.
Yes, you're giving me a migraine.
You said that?
Who said that then?
Look, you were.
I think I said that you're. You won't have a word yourself, you in the dark room, have you heard her?
Just cover your ears. Just cover your ears.
Look at me. Will you look at me? L-O-O-K, me. L-O-O-K, me. Do you want to go to Bridlington this weekend?
You know I do.
Well, sit up straight, because you're going to get yourself a lunch back. You're going to give me a frambuesa here. I'm too upset about this now. Look what you've done. We are not going to Bridlington. I've had it. Where were we?
Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson. Yeah, he has got some good moves of his own that he didn't steal from us, hasn't he?
Yes.
Show him some of the moves that he taught you. Give the dog here.
Oh, okay.
Go on. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. Hold on. When did he do that then? What video did he do that in?
Beat Me.
Daddy beat me, daddy beat me, daddy beat me, bastard daddy beat me. Daddy beat me, daddy beat me, bastard daddy beat me, daddy beat me, bastard daddy beat me.
daddy beat me better.
Beat me? She's molting here. Is this showing up on camera? I've got bloody hairs all over me.
The first Michael Jackson record that I bought was probably Bad, I think.
That's the first one I'd heard properly when I knew who he was, and I've never bought any of his songs.
I invented Bad as well, potentially.
Would it be okay if myself and Brian recite some of Michael's beautiful lyrics so you can understand why his fans are so loyal? Is that okay? I'd like to recite the lyrics from The Way You Make Me Feel. Ain't nobody's business but mine and my baby's. Go on, girl. Ow. My lonely days are gone. Hee hee.
Oh, chicka, 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 chicka. Go on, girl. Hee hee. The way you make me feel. Hee hee hee. You really turn me on. You knock me off my feet.
That's awesome. Hey, Brian, which is your favorite word out of all those lyrics?
Chicka.
I thought it would be chicka. Chicka, chicka.
I like the one where he did the bit where it went, ooh, I like that one.
Michael's videos were amazing though, weren't they? Mr. Whippy Ice Cream Face! Excuse me. Sorry, Steve. Should be working.
I think that was Dancing on the Ceiling. Oh, what a feeling. I can't believe it's amazing.
Yeah.
That one.
My favorite Michael Jackson video would have to be Bad. Because, you know, the dude was bad.
Bad. Oh, that's the gangs.
Yeah.
Gangs.
Because what I used to like is that they had that 3-hour film before it. And on Bad, it was directed by Martin Scorsese. It was black and white at first, yeah, which was obviously an analogy for darkness, moroseness, moronicness, yeah, travesty and poverty.
Come on, give me 50p. Da.
What do you say, love? I don't understand what you're saying.
Come on, da. Give me 50p.
I don't understand. I don't understand. Not at all.
Come on, give me 50p.
I don't know. I don't understand what you're saying. Sorry, mate.
Run, motherfucker, run! What the fuck are you doing? I was saving the old guy from this brutality. Y'all know that I like old people and animals and such.
Fuck off, you idiot, cause you ain't bad.
You ain't bad.
You ain't bad.
And then when music came on, it went colour, which was obviously to demonstrate magical realms in which Michael Jackson can pull you into so you can enjoy his music and stuff like that.
Schindler's List, that were black and white and all.
Oh, yes, I am bad. I'm a bad motherfucker, Shamon.
Moonwalking, you know, Mike comes to me and he's got this idea, and I'm like, Mike, you've lost the plot. There is no plot.
The movie be called Moonwalker. I ain't bothered about no plot line or story like that. It's all about the visuality. It start off, I'm being chased by people with big fucking plasticine heads.
Hold up for a second there, Mike.
Shut the fuck up. I'm in my flow here. Then I escape on a bunny rabbit on a bicycle. Then I turn into a car and I drive to a 1930s nightclub where I do the lean.
Who's Lalene? Some chick you've met.
Jay, it's a dance move. Chamon, you know that, right?
That's seriously amazing.
See how low I go.
That's no right, John?
You're loathing a pig's arsehole.
Kiss my bare self. Ow! This badass, right, John? Then I turn into Big Ben. Then I turn into a badass robot. Transformer robot. It's firing lasers out of the eyes and from my hands. And this is the noise they make, John. Ooh, ooh, do the noise, John.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
That's right, John knows the noise. Then I do a concert and I sing Come Together by the Beatles, because I own all that shit. And that's the movie right there. And it's gonna come out as a video game too, and come out on the Mega Drive, and come out for the Master System, for the poor kids.
Mikey, man, I'd love to do it, but I can't, you know. I've taken series number two of Casualty.
Casualty? What the fuck is Casualty?
It's a hospital drama. A lot like ER, but on a smaller scale, you know. But long-term contract, pays us one duties with the wife and kids and all that, you know.
Well, you know that guy, Richard Attenborough?
He'd do it, I think.
Get that motherfucker.
I remember it like it was just then, when he came to the United Kingdom to see his waxy worky at the Madame Tussaud, and it was a whole ruckus and a fracas. It was a pandemonium. It was a hysteria. It was Insania by Peter Andre. It was a hoopla-de-da-de-doo. And all the fans, they would scream like this. Believe it, look just like you.
Michael, what's it like to look at yourself?
It's amazing to look at myself. I look just like this. It got the same nose, it got the same mouth and chin. I know that I got this shirt at home. It's bad right there. I want to meet the bastard that made this and congratulate that motherfucker. Shamon, that's bad right there. Ow!
I'm the man responsible for the Mickey J waxwork at Madame Tussauds. I've done over 100 waxworks for them. I'll show you just a few of them right now. Here we've got Whoopi Goldberg in her sister act formation. You can see that it's looking like her, doesn't it? She's not smiling on that one. This one that we've got is Arnold Schwarzenegger in his Terminator formation. This one's gonna be his hand right there. But you notice that it's got no pants on. I always keep the pants off. That's my sort of signature thing. But I make sure the top doesn't come down so there's no willy showing, because it's a family show. Move well away. This one is Mike Myers from the film Austin Powers. And they didn't send me a picture, so it looks a bit like Prince as well. This one is his nemesis. That's Dr. Evil. And that was really difficult, getting the smoothness of the head. Twice I nearly contemplated suicide doing that one. You can see I've got the logo right there saying, Austin, I'm going to get you at the end of the film. And this one, well, you can see it always, can't you? This one is obviously David Beckham. And it's an action shot. As you can see, he's trying to head the ball. And that was a difficult rig. We've got two shatterproof rulers here, and that's what's keeping the ball up right there. When's this on telly like?
Well, I can easily rectify your problem. If you just pull it out at mains and then plug it back in, then the green light will come on, yes. Just wait till the green light comes on. I remember when Jackson Mania hit... Kes, behave, will you? I remember when Jackson Fever hit the UK, the whole world even, and he did the advert for the television, Pesky Cola, where his hair got set on fire, and he didn't realise for a whole week... Will you get out of my shot, they're filming me? I'll continue. It was a full week until he realised that his hair was on fire. That's 7 days. Check it out.
There's a badass motherfucking shot right there. Kiss my bare self. Ow! It's Wednesday and I'm climbing the trees and shit like that.
Don't worry.
Jamal, I turn the key.
Don't worry, be happy.
And all that time he was on fire and he didn't even realise. Can you imagine the excruciating pain? It don't bear thinking about, does it? It'd be worse than getting stung by a wasp on your bell end or your minge piece. Minge piece.
That's disgusting.
You're disgusting, the very sight of you. you minge piece. You piece of minge.
As well as his head, Michael had burnt up the whole of his right arm completely. Now, we couldn't replace the arm until the technology was as advanced as the West End stage musical Chutter, Chutter, Bang, Bang. So until that time, we replaced the arm temporarily with a balloon.
I like my balloon arm, Doctor. That's floaty.
Of course, the medical term for the balloon arm is the balarm.
I had a balarm myself. It burst.
At this time, there was a lot of speculation in the press that Michael was sleeping in an oxygen chamber. Baloney. He was indeed sleeping on a sunbed that we had rented from Tantastic in Peckham. We told Michael that this was a healing chamber. He believed this BS. BS, of course, stands for bullshit. So as Michael lay there, we removed his balarm and replaced it with the leg of Heather Mills. Right now, in Michael's period of his career, if you were to remove his sparkly glove, then you would indeed find a foot. And now, of course, the medical term for the hand foot is the hoot.
What the fuck you done to me, Doctor?
That's your new hoot.
What the fuck?
Had a what? A hoot? A what? A hoot?
What is a hoot, though?
A hoot.
Potentially, the hoot was my idea. I invented it, potentially.
You don't hear about that sort of thing in press, though, do you?
Is that why you wore the glove? To hide the hoot? Oh, my gosh, I never knew that.
And that was the start of Michael Jackson's obsession with his appearance. Boy, look good to me.
Then, facially, he changed his appearance facially to look like Diana Ross facially.
I don't believe that Michael wanna look like me.
And that's when he did it, didn't he? That's when it went all wrong.
Michael was so upset with his appearance, he decided to go under the knife again. This time, we gave him the full kit and caboodle. And I bought a yacht out of that shit. I got myself a Mega Drive, the Super SNES. I got this little Pac-Man you put in your pocket. Got one of them, too. Michael Jackson, meet the new Michael Jackson. You look like the face from the A-Team. Beautiful.
I look beautiful, like a teapot.
Do you think to the plastic surgeon? I don't think he had any. I think it's a lie.
I mean, he said that he had two nose jobs, and
No, he hasn't had two nose jobs.
I think that.
Hasn't had any, has he?
Hello, everybody. I'm Oprah Winfrey, and I'm one of the most powerful women in America today. Why, I could buy the whole of Kentucky Fried Chicken franchise worldwide, through and through. Get some of that beans and course on the side and shit. Today, I'm coming to you live from Neverland with Mr. Michael Jackson. So, Michael, tell me what the hoo-ha they do to your chin, because you definitely got a knee on that chin. What did those cruel bastards do to you, Michael?
Oh, but that's just crazy. That's stupid doopy doo. That's why I paid him, bish.
Bless you, my little honeypot. They definitely did something. What do they do to your crazy Disney frog eyes? Because you got them crazy Disney frog eyes right there. What old bastards do to you, Michael?
That's stupid. That's stupid doopy doo right there.
You don't want to be fucking stupid. Michael, tell your Auntie Oprah what they done to your eyebrows. You definitely got the McDonald's emblem across your eyes there. I want to buy that franchise too and give me some free chicken nuggets and get some sweet and sour sauce. What they done to your eyebrows? Tell Auntie Oprah, those cruel bastards.
That's insane in the membrane. Why would I do such a thing? That's crazy, bish. That's why I paid them, bish. Why would I do that, bish?
So we set the record straight. They ain't done nothing to Michael's face. Join me after the break when Michael will be teaching me how to do the moonwalk. I'm gonna kick off my high heels and get out my big toes and rub them down with some cocoa butter and get a hot tub. Obviously, Michael's voice changed in pitch and tone because we took his testicles and placed them in his cheeks. Now, the medical term for this is bollocks cheeks. Now, it's almost mandatory in L.A. for people to have bollocks injections.
I got a bollocks here, a bollocks here. They even put in a cleft chin like Kirk Douglas between the two bollocks.
I have bollocks injections here. I have bollocks injections here.
Another bollocks here. Hell, Mike and I were the king of bollocks. We'd buy bollocks every week.
Yes. Well, you will need a phone line. Hold on a second. It was about this time that he did the Earth song, which he performed at the Brix. And did you know that was one of his biggest selling singles? Did you know that? No, did you, Hummus? What about frying pan? Oh! What about cheese? Oh! What about the common man chewing on bees? Oh! What about the bunny rabbit?
There's no doubt about it. He was potentially world-class, and if he was still here with us, he could have been as big as Leona Lewis, who I invented. Potentially.
What the fuck you doing, motherfucker? Shanti, get this skinny tramp off the stage. I'm being Jesus right now, saving the kids, motherfucker. Get the fuck off the stage, Shamon. Motherfucker, get the fuck out of here. Get out of here. That's why I'm here, Shanti. You know that. I'm saving the kids, Shanti. I'm saving the kids!
Freya, man, look at the finger. See what's happening? I don't even know whose fingers this is. But it's bending. Slowly, right? I can do these things. See? He's bending, right? So, I hypnotized Michael. And I asked him the question. The question everybody wants to ask. Michael. Will you be my friend?
Yuri, that be stupid. You know that I'm your friend, even though I only met you 6 times.
Yes, my friend. So I make up this character, and I tell Michael he can get a good deal on 2-week holiday on the moon. Michael is very excited because he wants to do his bloody moonwalk on the moon. But I know this is impossible because I have made this up, so Michael will be my friend.
Hi, Yuri, it's Michael Jackson. I'm really excited about the moon trip, but I want to be the first before NSYNC, Boyz II Men, Milli Vanilli, or any of them bitches. I love you, bitch. Bitch.
He sounded so gullible, so naive, and I'm listening to this, and I am masturbating. I am slamming my penis against the door. I have the penis inside this bag of nettles. The cat is scratching at it. This mouse is nibbling at my ballsack, and two doggies saying woof, woof, woof. And I am wrapping around this thread, around the bell end, until it's going blue, until there's blood coming out of the head. Really fucked up shit, you know?
I invented Uri Geller. Potentially.
So Michael would be my friend. I also told him that I know this dude who works at Matalan, and he can close down the whole store, and we can do shopping without any kind of harassment. We should honor Michael. We should honor Michael. We are going to be shopping until we are dropping. Michael is my friend. Look at our fingers. Bent, right? I don't even know whose finger this is. Come on, we are going to have great bargains. Great bargains. What's up, Michael? Calm down. You're excited, right? Let's go find some bargains. Nice buttocks. Michael, look at this. Pack of three spots, suck. Only $4.99. We should get this, you know.
You come here. Come here. This is not Matalan. This is JJJBBB spots. I wanted to go to Madeline. Where's the back to school sale? They don't have that here. This is not Madeline.
Michael, you are correct. This is not Madeline. I don't know no dude who work at Madeline. But I actually know this dude who work at JJJBB spots. And he has closed the whole place down for us. So we can buy all these baggage like yoga mat. Look.
It's don't do yoga, you know
it's that. Bending like big pink penis. Oh, this golf umbrella, you like this, right? Look, he's bending. Keep watching.
You don't like golf. It's scary. That's scary. The little balls might get inside like you, Yuri. This is not Madeline.
Look at this. What is this crazy contraption? You should use this for when you are working out like this, when you are doing the car. It make you very fit in the buttocks, right? Look at this.
This is not Madeline.
It's fantastic. Michael, look at this. Judo costume.
They got judo suits. Yuri, that's beautiful. Get two of them and put one in there for yourself.
Michael, you don't know how happy this is making me being.
That's beautiful. I love judo suits. I want to be the black belt.
Michael is my friend. I'm so happy. I am pressing popcorn into my penis very hard. Really fucked up shit, you know. Despite this, I introduced him to my friend, Martin Bashir. Fuck. I should never have done this because this was Michael's downfall.
Michael, as we've walked around Neverland, we've noticed there's a lot of steak and kidney pies.
Yes.
We even saw some in your bedroom. Do you think it's right that a 44-year-old man should sleep with steak and kidney pies?
Yes.
Steak and kidney pie, steak and kidney pie.
Why does he sing this ridiculous song?
Steak and kidney pie, pie. Do you think that's appropriate?
Marty, why do you do these things, Marty? Why do you ask me these things? If you're asking, did I have sexual relations with a steak and kidney pie? Yes, I did. That is the most beautiful thing that a man can do. It's beautiful. It's beautiful, bitch. Steak and kidney pie? It's beautiful.
Must be the kitchen.
Oh! That's my pee, bitch.
Oh, whoa. Nasty boy.
Marty, what are you doing, bitch?
You know, in those days, everything was normal. Everybody had sex with steak and kidney pies.
Did you get that on camera? And cut? Michael, can I have a go? I'm very interested to see how this feels.
Just put some vinegar on it, that'll do it right. So, yeah, Michael Jackson was well vexed after that steak and kidney pie fiasco. Ix and Doocy. And he disappeared for a bit.
Do you want DVD?
Betamax! So, look then. You haven't got Toy Story, clear off. I'm sick of you coming round here unless you've got Toy Story. So, anyway, decided to bulk up with Incredible Hulk. He wanted to get proper tonks, you know what I mean? Neil Buchanan, Steve Jones, Donkey Mouth! So I get this call on the intercom from this guy who says he's Michael Jackson. I said, this is Michael Jackson from the Jackson 5. I say, yo, Michael! Yeah, Michael! He said he wants to get his body like a dancer. So I say, come down to the gym. We'll get you doing some cardio. I say, yeah, Michael! No doubt. Go, Michael! Push it! Keep pushing, Michael! Very good, Michael! You can do it! You can do it, Michael! Keep going, Michael! Yeah, Michael! Yeah, Michael! Yeah, Michael! Yeah, Michael! Go, Michael! Push it, Michael! Very good, Michael! Yeah, Michael! Okay, let's take a break, then we do some squats, no doubt.
I am not speaking to Michael for some time. And I am missing vigorously masturbating and sticking cactus up my crack while hearing his voice. So I telephoned Michael and I tell him I know this dude who is alien and he can take him away to a galaxy far, far away to a planet that does not exist. I'm making this up so he will be my friend. Here, he is safe from any kind of bad press. All you have to do to communicate to this man is to say the code word on television. This is it! This is it! And my alien friend will come to him at the O2 Center. Very nice, bitch. This is shit. These are tits? The alien's coming? What is it? What is one? What? 2 seconds. To get the code to the aliens. You, it's Michael Jackson, bitch. What be the code for the aliens again?
This is it!
That's what I see, bitch. This is it. This is it. This is it. Can I see the aliens?
No, sir, you'll actually need the box, otherwise you don't get the channels. Yes, that's correct. And unfortunately, that was it.
He's dead?
And I bought a ticket and all. Still ain't got me money back. Can I get a refund? Sorry.
We were both outbroken that Michael Jackson died. But I, specifically, don't think he's actually dead. Because remember when we were speaking to Kevin Webster from Coronation Street? Yeah. He said the same thing about Bruce Lee. How can the fittest man alive die? It's like Elvis don't think he's dead, neither is Tupac Shakur. And I think they're all in a fish and chip... They all work in a fish and chip shop in Sheffield, probably.
Michael will be remembered as the greatest entertainer of all time. And I know when he watches this in the greater place in the world, in heaven, he'll be laughing because he knows that all of us love him so much for the great music that he gave us that will live on forever.
I like those cooler Kobe, but don't forget about the mark.